So welcome to this lecture. We are here to discuss
even mechanism with evidence.
What is the even mechanism and what are the evidences which are responsible for or which are the basic or which give the idea what is the mechanism of even mechanism. To understand this concept, we will go for a specific mechanism or we will go for a specific example. Okay. So you see, you just go for this one example. Okay. So this is what the alkyl halides we are discussing. And our aim is to learn about the even mechanism followed by this substrate or this reactant. We are very well familiar with the type of alkyl halide. This is alkyl halide. It is the tertiary alkyl halide. The reason is, in this compound, halogen is attached to a carbon which is a tertiary carbon. Therefore, with the tertiary halide, remember, all tertiary halides, they undergo elimination reaction, and that is even elimination reaction. If tertiary halides are subjected for the substitution reaction, so such tertiary halides show SN1 reaction, this unimolecular reaction. So where we are taking this one, and we are using sodium ethoxide as a base in ethanol or ethyl alcohol. What is the product we are expecting? So first of all, you know, we have to find out the alpha carbon. This is the alpha carbon. This is the beta carbon. This is also beta carbon. This is also product. And we are familiar with, or we know this, that all elimination reactions, including E1, E2, E1CD, their final product is alkene. And the number of products which are formed in such elimination reaction are governed by the Sezeff rule. What is the Sezeff rule? It is the rule which tells us that more substituted alkenes are more in amount because they are more stable because of plus I effect. So how many compounds are possible here? How many alkenes are possible? And when Sezeff is applicable, Sezeff rule. So remember, Sezeff is applicable when two or more than two beta carbons are present. Otherwise, no need of Sezeff rule. Sezeff rule is applicable only when there is a presence of two or more than two beta carbon. Here there are three beta carbon, but these two are same because methyl, so we can say overall two types of beta carbon. This is a one type. There is a formation of two alkenes, so we can write CH3, this H, this Br will go and double bond will be there, and this carbon and this CH3. So one possibility is this one. Another product will be this side, right? Yes. This side, so we can write CH3, CH2. This one. I can write here this CH2 and this side CH2. So two products formation takes place. there are two products. So this would be major definitely, because even the reaction takes place by following this Sezif rule, by following the Sezif rule, and this is the product. If we go for the mechanism, and we know the mechanism of E1 is, mechanism of E1 is two steps. So first step is what? Step 1 is formation of carbocation. Next step 1 is formation of carbocation from alkyl halide, and it's a very slow step. So we can see it is a RDS. It is a very determining step. So see how it is formed. Let us take this example. CH2C is the Br, this side CH3, down CH3, and very slow step. We can say a very determining step. Why? Because this bromine formation, bromine loss takes place. And there is no formation of. Okay? If you see here, CBr bond breakage takes place, this carbocation will form. That's the first step. What is the second step? Step 2 is what? What is step 2? Step 2 is what? Loss of H plus from beta carbon, right? Yes. So this is beta carbon, this is beta carbon, this is beta carbon. So if we take this one as a beta carbon, so that H will lose. So we can say CH3 bond CH, one hydrogen here, C, there is a CH3 and positive charge. You see here, this bond shook like this, and we can say there is a formation of double bond and balance. It is a two-step reaction. E1 elimination is the two-step reaction, and the first step is a slow step, that is a rate determining step. We can say the first step is responsible for the rate of a chemical reaction. So we can write this rate is directly proportional to concentration of this alkyl. We can balance. Yes or no? Yes, we can balance. Now, what are the evidences that only this mechanism is followed by the E1 mechanism or followed by the E1 reaction? So, there are three evidences, and for E2 reactions, you can also watch that video. For E2 reaction also. There are evidences. So number one evidence, we go for evidences. Evidences ka meaning kya hai? Okay, that this is the particular mechanism is followed by this reaction, that is provided by the certain examples. So let us go for the first evidence is. Okay, first evidence is, what we go for that? The first evidence is kinetic effect. We can say no kinetic effect. What is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of this? See, we will take example. See, same example we will take. Suppose we have taken this one.
see here. See.
See, if we have taken this one. Okay,
right?
Yes. And we are writing adding Na sodium ethoxide. Okay, sodium ethoxide is. And there is a formation of the product, right? There is a formation of product, see. CH3, CH double bond C, CH3. And suppose this is the, our target is this one. What is our aim? Our aim is to study this reaction is following SNE1 or not. This reaction is twin step or not. How we can find out that? The first evidence is no panic effect. What is the meaning of no panic effect? So what we do now? Replace these two hydrogen. Because in kinetic effect, we study the isotopic labeling also. Another name is isotopic labeling. So replace this all beta hydrogen by isotope. So this is the deuterium, this is the deuterium, this 3 deuterium and 3 deuterium and Br. So now you add same, if you add same base, but here if this CD bond is going to break, no problem. And let us write the product. CD3. What is the meaning of this? This suppose KH is the KD is the rate of this isotopic labeled reaction, and this is KH is the rate constant for this. If rate constant KH is equal to KD, means no change in the this deuterium labeling. No change is observed in the rate of reaction by doing deuterium changing. It means that rate is not depend on this CH bond breaking or CD bond breaking. It means that rate is not depend on this C, because it is a beta carbon. What is that? It is a beta carbon. It is a beta carbon. And we learn that beta carbon breakage do not take place in E1. E1 mein kya hota hai? E1 mein alpha carbon and this halogen atom breakage takes place. And second step is what? The breakage of beta carbon and hydrogen bond. And that is the first step. What is the slow step? This first step is slow step, and it is a rate determining step. अगर ये रेट में चेंज होता, इसका मीनिंग ये होता, रेट कांस्टेंट में की वैल्यूज में, इसका मीनिंग ये होता कि रेट इज डिपेंड ऑन दिस ब्रेकेज ऑफ सी बी बॉन्ड्स एज, एंड इफ इट इज देयर चेंज, इट इज द ई2 रिएक्शन मैकेनिज्म, इट इज नॉट ई1 मैकेनिज्म. सो फ्रॉम दिस ऑनगोइंग डिस्कशन इट इज क्लियर दैट दिस वैल्यू ऑफ दिस रेट कांस्टेंट फॉर दिस and this isotopic labeled reaction is same. It means that rate is not depend on the beta carbon hydrogen or beta carbon deuterium bond breakage. Okay, that is a very fast or rate is independent thing. So rate is depend on only CBr bond breaking. Okay, that's all. This is what the first evidence which says that the bond breakage takes place, that is between alpha carbon and halogen. Okay. Hope you understand this point. Next point. Next evidence is what? What is the next evidence? So we'll go for the next evidence in the support of E1 reaction. In the support of E1 reaction, I will write the next evidence. It's again interesting one. It is about the structural effects. It is about the structural effect. What is the structural effect? The structural effect of the reactant. The structural effect of the reactant. How we can say this one thing? So we know that. Let us go for the example first of all. So if you take this tertiary alkyl halides. Okay, we know tertiary alkyl halide. Tertiary alkyl halide. Okay, rate. Okay, tertiary alkyl halide rate is very higher than secondary alkyl halide. Secondary alkyl halide rate, and it is higher than the primary alkyl halide. Primary alkyl halide rate. Primary alkyl halide rate. And from this ongoing discussion, it can be clear that why tertiary alkyl halide and when you get secondary alkyl halide and you perform the reaction. So it is found that the rate of tertiary alkyl halide is very fast. Why? The reason is what? This tertiary alkyl halide gives tertiary carbocation. Yes or no? Yes. This tertiary alkyl halide produces tertiary carbocation, and this tertiary carbocation stabilized by alkyl groups. Yes or no? Yes. Alkyl groups by plus I effect. More the number of alkyl groups, more is the stable carbocation. Similarly, this will produce secondary carbocation. This will produce secondary carbocation, which is stabilized but by less number of alkyl groups, and here this will produce primary carbocation, and that will not stabilize by that number of alkyl groups that are stabilizing carbocation number of alkyl groups in secondary interface. So this is the one more support for the evidence that the reaction which involving tertiary carboalkyl halides is more stable compared to our rate is very fast compared to the primary, and definitely for tertiary it is the highest rate. Okay, so we have learned this two evidences. So third evidence is what? We'll go for the third evidence. Okay, yes. So hope you understand this. What is the third evidence? Now you see, third evidence is again very interesting. Okay, fine. So now, third evidence about it is about rearrangement. Okay, rearrangement. Okay, what is the meaning of this one? Okay, so what happened is, see here. For example, we will take an example. And we will try to understand this. Okay, fine. Okay, right. See here. See one example. We can see this is the example. CH3. To understand the arrangement, we are taking this example. CH3, CH, and here we take one more CH and CH3 and Br. It is a secondary alkyl halide. Yes or no? Yes. And when we perform the reaction with the any base, you know, for example any OET, so it is a very slow reaction process. Why? There is a breakage of this bond space and formation of secondary carbocation. This is the secondary carbon. Yes or no? This is the secondary carbon. Secondary carbon. Now what happens to this now? There are two chances, because two beta carbon, one beta carbon, another beta carbon. So now this H will lost, double bond will be here, so we can write Seisser product C like this. Yes or no? Double bond CH and CH. What is that? Seisser. It is Seisser product, right? Yes. It is the Seisser product. But if you see this one, this H and this beta carbon is going to loss. So there is a formation of which product? Yes, Hoffmann product. There is a formation of Hoffmann product. There is a formation of Hoffmann product. Okay. So two products possible. This is the less and there is a more. Right. This is the less. This is the more. This is the less. But what happens in even the reaction type system? Sometimes what happens? So now I write here to understand the idea. So three valences are there. See now what happens sometimes? Rearrangement takes place. See? In even the reaction, rearrangement takes place in carbocation. So this is secondary carbocation. So I write here CH3CH plus and CH2. What happens in this actually? This is a secondary carbocation. We can write secondary carbocation. Secondary carbocation. So what happens to this reaction? Rearrangement takes place, but secondary becomes tertiary and primary becomes secondary. Secondary. So how? This bond takes trans migration takes place. This complete migration occur from this carbon to this carbon, and there's a development of charge on that carbon. So we can write CH3, CH2, CH3, and there is a bond. So this is what rearrangement. It is a one of the property that occur in that is occur in the what in even reaction mechanism, in even reaction mechanism. So this formation of this rearrangement of this secondary carbocation to tertiary carbocation definitely is an evidence for the mechanism that follow the even system. Fine. So hope you understand this idea. So now if you perform the elimination reaction for this one, if this is going under elimination reaction, so what product will get? Two new products are possible now. Again two new products. So double bond will be there in this side, you see. Again here, okay. So CH3, it is different from other compound, you see. Okay, yes, and here it is a product, and one more chance is from this side. So we can write, you see, carbon double bond CH2 and 3. So this is matched here, but this is third. This is one example, one second, and this is the third alkene which is formed in the rearrangement process. And this is possible only in E1 mechanism. Rearrangement is not possible in E2 mechanism. So these three evidences tells us that isotopic effect has no impact on rate of reaction. That's KH is equal to KD. Second point we have learned that is what about the structural changes. Tertiary alkyl rates are more stable. More give more rate. Why? Because they form tertiary carbocation which are more stable. And the third evidence we came to know about rearrangement, which is only possible in E1 type of reaction. Okay. So hope you understand this concept. So we have discussed this. Okay, fine. So any question? Yes, so we can ask the question.